Hello, in this video we'll explain how to use the EfficientIP Dynamic Inventory plugin for Ansible. So we start with an IPAM in which we have a space with a full hierarchy of networks. And in a Device Manager we have plenty of devices. In the first use case we demonstrate how to use a basic template for the inventory plugin. It uses parameters to connect to the SOLID server. When using the Ansible command to get the information from the inventory, here we just display the information and we are not performing any action. So here we have the result from the extract, and since we have made a no filter, we get all the devices that we have in the inventory. The query takes a few seconds, as you've seen, because it grabs the whole inventory of 6,000 nodes, roughly. And we have all the nodes, like seen on the screen, from our device inventory. So this is basic example, getting the full device manager list. But the interest of this inventory is to add some filters. The first one is very simple. It's just limiting the output. So for sure, the query executes very fast here, and we grab only the five first devices. So in another example, we do a filter by a specific space we have in the IPAM. Here the space is named local. So let's first have a look to the Device Manager with interfaces. In the local space, we only have one device in this case. So let's check the output of the inventory command. Should display this specific node filtered by the space. So this device has an interface in this space. The next example is getting devices that has an interface with an IP address in a specific subnet. So just check from the IPAM within this specific subnet what kind of devices we have, and the result here is 17 devices with an IP address in this subnet, and this is what we will try to extract from Device Manager. So we will grab all the devices with an interface in this subnet, and through the inventory we get exactly those 17 devices. So that's enable us to apply a playbook to only part of the network devices. In the next example we will more focus on a new notion, which is the grouping. So in addition to filtering the devices that are in a subnet, we do group. We do construct groups based on a specific metadata, which is called environment here. And then we have in our inventory some groups on which the devices are located, and we'll be able in the playbook to filter by group. So if we do the same on the Device Manager, we can see the environment metadata. So manipulating this metadata directly in Device Manager will change for sure the result we have in the inventory of Ansible. In the next example, we will use multiple filters. So here we are filtering on multiple information. The first one is a class. So we would like from Device Manager all the devices that are configured with a specific class. Here we want to have the AWS server located. And in addition, we want to have a specific environment. We selected a test environment, so we have only three servers in AWS and in the environment test. So when we do the extract with Ansible, we got only those three devices. And the last example we propose here is to combine a filter and a grouping. And here, as you can see, we do a group on a different metadata than the one we have used for filtering. So here we want the AWS servers in the environment production, and we want to perform a specific grouping that will be available for the playbook if the playbook wants to use it. So here the result, we have the server grouped by the region, the region from an AWS perspective. And then in the playbook, we will be able to use a specific region as an extract of these five servers. So as a takeaway, Ansible can run local inventory. You probably know that without any problem, but whenever we manage large data set, it starts to be very, very complex to maintain. So here with an IPAM, you can build very complex automation scenario. And we will see how to perform that in our next video on the playbooks.